A liquid in a container exerts forces on the walls and bottom of the container. Remember that pressure is defined as the force per unit area on which the force acts. The pressure that a block exerts on a table is just the weight of the block divided by its area of contact. The pressure a liquid in a cylindrical container exerts against the bottom of the container is the weight of the liquid divided by the area of the container bottom. For now, we'll ignore the additional atmospheric pressure. The liquid exerts a pressure against the bottom of its container, just as the block exerts a pressure against the table. How much a liquid weighs, and therefore how much pressure it exerts, depends on its density. For the same depth, a denser liquid exerts more pressure. Mercury is 13.6 times as dense as water. For the same volume of liquid, the weight of mercury is 13.6 times the weight of water. The pressure of mercury on the bottom is 13.6 times the pressure of water. For any given liquid, the pressure on the bottom of the container will be greater if the liquid is deeper. In picture A, the liquid in the first container is twice as deep, so the pressure on the bottom is twice of that in the second container. In picture B, two blocks exert twice as much pressure on the table. The pressure of a liquid at rest doesn't depend on the shape of the container or the size of its bottom surface. Liquids are practically incompressible, so the density of a liquid is normally the same at all depths. The pressure created by a liquid is equal to density times G times depth. The total pressure of a liquid is density times G times depth plus the pressure of the atmosphere. When this distinction is important, we use the term total pressure. Otherwise, our discussions of liquid pressure refer to pressure in addition to the normally ever-present atmospheric pressure. The pressure of a liquid does not depend on the amount of liquid. Neither the volume nor even the total weight of liquid matters. The water pressure is greater at the bottom of the deeper lake. The dam holding back water twice as deep must withstand greater average water pressure, regardless of the total volume of water. The pressure of the liquid is the same at any given depth below the surface, regardless of the shape of the container. These Pascal vases illustrate that water pressure depends on depth and not on volume. The water surface in each of the connected vases is at the same level. Pressures at equal depths are the same. At the bottom of all four vases, for example, the pressures are equal. At any point within a liquid, the forces that produce pressure are exerted equally in all directions. When you're swimming underwater, no matter which way you tilt your head, your ears feel the same amount of water pressure. When the liquid is pressing against the surface, there's a force from the liquid directed perpendicular to the surface. If there's a hole in the surface, the liquid initially will move perpendicular to the surface. Gravity causes the path of the liquid to curve downward. At greater depths, the net force is greater, and the velocity of escaping liquid is greater.